Children of God now. Amen? Let the word of God come out from your mouth. So once you talk, somebody will know that you are a Christian. Amen? Praise God. Number one, substance addiction. E.g. drugs abuse. These are substance addiction. People are used to it. There are people who were millionaires before because of drugs. They're finished. You ruin them. Amen? One of the greatest musicians, Whitney Houston, she was one of the greatest in her time. It shaped the whole world. The only thing that succeeded in destroying her is drugs. Destroy her, destroy the daughter, finish the family. Praise God. So drug is a powerful thing. People that are on drug, they are not my friend. Even you are my brother. Praise God. You can't make billions from it, then I will be saying that you make money. No. Amen. So any money that you make from drugs, you should think the number of people that you have killed. If they said that that man is a murderer, you also you know that you are part of it. Amen. I pray that the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Then cocaine, opioid, heroin, amphetamine, benzodiazepine. Any way I pronounce it, I'm not into drugs. Praise God. Amen. God will help us. Tramadol, codeine, crack, inhalant, alcoholism, smoking, cigarettes, tobacco, vaporizer, marijuana, nicotine, caffeine, coffee, Coke, Cola. Praise God. Amen. They are not talking about Coca-Cola.
Praise
God. And yes, when you are addicted to it, there are people, they always need something that is sweet. They don't drink any other thing. Praise God. It's not good to hurt anyone. Even if it is free for you to drink anything that is sweet, but it's not helpful. Amen?
Amen.
It's not helpful. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. The other one is behavioral or process addiction. Praise God. 1 Kings chapter number 11, 4 to 5, quickly. And somebody put to Proverbs 31, verse 3.
As Solomon grew old, his wife turned his heart after other gods, and his heart was not fully devoted to the Lord, his God. As the heart of David, his father, had been. 5. He followed Astoreth, the goddess of the Sodomites, and Moloch, and detestable god of Ammonites.
Praise God. Detestable god of the gods that are detest, that God don't like, you know. If Solomon was having, God gave him privileges. Praise God. Amen. Even if through his father that God have established that kingdom, through David. He said, a man after my own. It's because of David that God have established that kingdom. Praise God. Amen. And he passed it to Solomon. Solomon was born with a boy with silver spoon. Praise God. Amen. But he misused it. The privileges. First privilege God has given to us now. Most of us are misusing it. And God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So behavioral or process addiction. Not just drugs. The way you behave. You understand when you spend time in Facebook more than the time you spend in doing a normal thing that a normal person is supposed to do. Praise God. Amen. So if all your time is on Facebook, you know that you are no longer a normal person. Praise God. Amen. A normal person, you have to program yourself. There are things you do that are normal. Right from the beginning. God, our God is a great God. And he's a normal God. Praise God. He's a God of step by step.
Amen.
Amen. So God has power to create everything one day. Not so. Why did God have to what? Do it step by step. Amen. So God wants his children to do things in a way that are normal, step by step, do it accordingly. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Even if you can finish the whole food in the house one day, it does not mean it's not a normal thing for you to finish it one day. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. There are quantities that you are supposed to eat in the morning, in the what? In the afternoon, in the evening, next day. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. It's not that when you are, okay, I have food in there, I will finish all today. Either you finish the food or the food finish you. It's two ways. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 This addition to mode altering activities or objects such as gambling, smartphone, and social media platforms. Praise God.
Amen.
The internet, love and relationship, sexual activities, masturbation, sex, pornography, etc. Eating disorder. I said it before, that was our first. Eating disorder. Spending. You always, when you, somebody open your phone, you are always on the west side of offer. Offer. Offer will never finish. The person will die. Even if the person die now, there will still be offer. Praise God. If they bring 50% today in the money, if you are not careful, go to that website again, they will bring 30%. Amen. The other day will bring 15, they will turn it to 40, they will turn it to... They play with people. Amen. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. So eat in a way, in an orderly manner. Don't eat, you must, you know, children don't have, that we also want to correct children. Not can I have. If you allow children to have everything, they will eat in a disorder way. But anytime they come out, they get up from the chair, can I have? Sometimes when you say yes, you also say no. At least to be, so that their mouth will also be a space. Amen. So when you eat too much, you don't think well. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Number
Amen.
Two, power addiction. And this one is very, very good for where we are coming from. They lack power. Amen. I don't want to mention where we are. I know we are coming from upper place. I don't want to call it downtown by the grace of God. Amen. From those who are coming from overseas. Praise God. Power addiction is the kind of addiction associated with power, influence, and affluence. Proverbs chapter number 28, verse 15. Quickly. People who are addicted to power tend to feel more powerful when they are dominating other people. With little patience for anything that stands in the way of their upward path. Dictator people. Presidents that are dictator. Anyone that stands against them is finished because they don't play with that power. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Where we are coming from. You can imagine one president spending one month. That's it. I have been there before you were born. And you are there now. You are spending 30 something years doing breakfast.
And the sun is coming up when you died.
Just imagine. These are the power people that are what? Addicted to power. And that man, anyone that stand on their way, what happened to them? They crush the person.
Yeah, let me read this. He said, poor people are helpless against wicked ruler. He is as dangerous as a roaring lion or a prowling bear. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Amen.
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 The poor people, what are they doing? They are helpless.
They are helpless.
It's only God that will help them.
Amen.
Amen. They don't have any choice. If you see people praising a dictator that is there for many years, and they are present, it's not their fault. They are already a victim. They don't have any choice. They are helpless in such situation. And God will help us in Jesus' name, and we help them. Amen. Say so they are what? Often extremely competitive and have a devastating need to be right. Example of King Saul and King Hezekiah. We understand the story of King Saul. Amen. But the situation came when he was rejected because he was now power addicted. What happened? He was looking for a way to take David out. By all means, whether he's a senior, I don't care. So I want that man what? Amen. They also were power addicted in the kingdom of God. It happened before. He said there was war in heaven. The little power that God had given to Lucifer, he became power drunk. Amen. That's what happened. He wanted to be like God. Like power addicted. Amen. He can also be in the church. Power addicted. Or altar addicted. When some pastor cleaned with their altar, nobody entered it. It's also power addicted. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. When you head of a department, you have been given little power. So everyone around you, you talk to them anyhow. You are power addicted. Praise God.
Amen.
And God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. And men also, you can also be power addicted in your family. I'm the man of the house. I'm the man. Praise God. Is it a battlefield? Amen. A place that is supposed to be a peaceful place we enjoy together. Is equal right? Everybody have equal right. Amen. Go to court. Court will tell you, your wife and you have 50% equal right. Amen. You are the man of the house, you are just dragging there. Forget that. Keep that one in your course. And do the right thing. Amen. The right thing is what? It's to love. That is your responsibility. If you love your wife, he said, love cover a multitude of sin. And love correct many things. Amen?
Amen.
You don't have to wait for your wife to submit to you. Don't wait. Do your part first. Leave her part to her. Amen?
God will help us.
Amen.
Amen. I hope that women are happy with me now. Hello, ma. Am I safe? Praise God. All right. D. Signs of addiction. What are the signs? Some signs of addiction may include developing a strong desire to use substance. You know that is a sign. People who are on drugs, they don't what? They can't stay with that. Any time that comes, that time comes to use that drug, you see them shaking. A strong desire to use that thing. Engaging in the problematic behavior. Praise God.
Yeah.
Amen. People that are addicted to alcohol, once they are drunk, you have to run away from them. Praise God. Because people that are drunk, they are very dangerous. They can carry out any action anytime. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
The Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Appearing dirty. Amen.
Amen.
The drug. People who are on drug now, drug have ruined their life, who are on the street.
Amen.
You can't see them, they are dressed in a very decent way. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. It turns on them. It changed them. As I said before, that alcohol will create in them a face. Drugs also give them another face. It will remove the normal face and give them a drug face.
Amen.
People that use drugs, you see them, you know from a distance that man. And God will help us in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen.
And we that are in the house of God, the faith that you have are very decent.
Amen.
You have the face of Christ.
Amen.
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 If I were you now, I would just smile. God will. Amen. All right. Okay. Inability to fulfill obligation at school, works, or home. If the previously enjoyed hobbies are abandoned because of addicted to something. Favor of use of substance. Withdrawal of symptoms.
Amen. A person with power addiction may experience obsession, extreme restlessness, and extreme cases may result to irrational, destructive behavior such as manipulation, violent, ego trip, or bribery to achieve goals and maintain the high. Praise God. Amen. If connect all together, both the drugs, the power, people that are addicted to power, they can do anything. They will involve in killing, bribing, corruption, because they want to what, keep that power. Praise God. Amen. 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 And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 And here, when 1 million leave, when a president spends some few thousands in a refurbishment in the apartment in Downing Street, you see people talking. Praise God. Where we are coming from is 100% that will disappear. Budget of 100% will just disappear. You see, the president will announce that billions of dollars, and they don't know how it goes in central bank.
Snake.
Amen. A monkey will eat some, okay. Snake will eat something. So where we are coming from, Africa, animals are eating money. Animals spend money. So we are proud of it.
God
will help us. Snake eat money, they spend money. And when we have poor people on the street, and snake have the privilege, the power to spend money, when human beings cannot spend in millions, God will help us.
All those wicked rulers that we are seeing everywhere, is it God that put them there?
Praise God. Amen. Amen. Okay, this is a question. Amen. Brother Muyan, do you have any answer to that?
I think sometimes those wicked rulers are actually a judgment of God in itself.
Yeah.
You know, for a nation that rejects God, God will say to you, okay, so if that's the way you want to carry on, I will give you a man to, you know. Yeah, so sometimes when you get a ruler like that, it's actually a judgment of God in itself.
That's good. Amen.
But so, on and on, for example, in Nigeria, I don't think we ever get a nice one.
Praise God. Amen. But if you check what is happening in Nigeria, amen, we need the intervention of God. And everyone needs to submit to God. Praise God. Though the bad rulers are there because the people that are saying, it's not only government that is bad. I can say most people are bad. The way they do some, if you see the kind of evil that are going on in that land, people that are dying or sacrificed in different corners. So there are ways that God will place somebody there to make it. If we have a bad leader, we should thank God that God is giving us time to repent. Praise God. God wants to know, giving us time to repent. God can also decide to bring an earthquake so that he finish everything. Because God wanted to do it when the Israelites messed up. He was telling Moses, give way. Let me just command the gun and swallow all these evil people. Amen. God can do it. But if we still have a bad leader now, we should not be saying bad leader, but we should also what? No, check our hearts. Check our nature. Are you good? You yourself. Are you good? Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. We are in everywhere. If you go to our embassy now, once you enter our Nigeria embassy, it changed from UK. Everything around there, our nature, our behavior, our sense, our mentality is Nigerian. We'll look for one way to block this way so that we expose people. You see, it's coming up. Amen. When you go there, we used to do passports, they will post it to you. Now they close that link. So that when you go there, they will, okay, you are not staying here. Okay, if you need your passport, no, 100 pounds. You can see the people. They will create, that is our nature. Even if we go, carry a pig from Africa, take it to US, it still remain pig. We are not pink by the grace of God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. But our mentality, our behavior need to change.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. God will help us in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Amen. All right, quickly, let's go.
Yeah.
Amen. Outline two. Curbing addiction. How do you curb it? How do you excuse it? How do you stop it? Amen. Take a stand. If you want to stop addiction, now what do you need to do? Now, anything that is taking your time, we mentioned about Facebook. There was a time I was spending, I don't know, you know, Facebook, when you enter, you flip one, another one come. Before you flip it, another one come. I'm not spending more time in Facebook. I removed the account. Praise God. Depends on how you want to say it. If you still want to see it, I removed the account. Amen? Because I know that it's becoming harmful to me now. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. So if you check our hand now, check your hand now. This hand is not, you find it difficult to stretch it. People are deformed here because of a smartphone, you see? Anyone. People are deformed, partially. Amen.
Amen.
And it's taking them out, taking people out. Enter Trump. At least 90% of people, once they sit down, the first thing they bring out is what? Phone. You see them, they flip it, they do it like this, they do it like this. Everybody. People are addicted to smartphone. And people in charge, they know. They will bring 7 this year. Before you know, they bring 8. The thing that you are still coming back. Before you finish that 8, they bring 9. And it's the same thing that is inside. Praise God. Because they know that there are people that are addicted to phone. Addicted to new phone. They will come back. God will help us in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And you can be addicted to the word of God. It's good. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, take a stand. As I took my stand many years ago against the cheap beer. Praise God.
Amen.
You must first acknowledge that addiction is an affliction and you are already caught up in it well. Understand that this thing is what? It's a dangerous game. As I said before, I use my personal experience in Facebook, spending time. I know that it becomes a web. Become what? I'm caught up in it. What did I need to do? I took my stand, I removed the account. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. That is the best way I want to stop it. But if I still leave it now, I can still come back. Maybe let me just check the message. I enter. From there, you see different story. You read this, you read the other one. And God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And if you are not careful, you see people posting the different nonsense video to your Facebook. If you don't correct your privacy well, set it well. The people, they share bad news. The most common thing to share now that have millions of views is what? Bad news. People like to watch bad news. But when it's good news, people do not share. And God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Then you must be willing to break free from its bondage while acknowledging that you cannot help yourself. Invite the Holy Spirit. Seek help. Amen?
Amen.
You seek help of the Holy Spirit, a child of God. In the secular world, what did they do? They also seek help. Amen. There are social homes. There are drug rehabilitation centers that they create to build up people, to correct people, to help people. It's also there in the secular world. But what do we have here? Our rehabilitation center that will change us is the word of God and the Holy Spirit. I did not go to any center to stop alcohol. Amen? But with the help of the word of God and the Holy Spirit, I know that it's not good for me. Amen?
Amen.
And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You must totally sincere and open to God that you need help. As well as to people who can be of help in breaking the evil habits. Amen. Praise God.
Mm-hmm.
What? Be open to God and be open to people who can be of help to you. Don't form. Don't have yourself. Bring down your ego if you need help. Surrender yourself
for proper screening and therapies. Pharmacotherapy, psychotherapy, and spiritual therapy. Everything is therapy. God will help us. Amen. You must surrender yourself to all this. Avoid relapse. Relapse is to addict, is to addiction what backsliding is to sin. And each episode is usually worse than before the treatment or deliverance. Amen. Amen. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. So in the word of God, as a child of God, you have not need to be lukewarm, to be relaxed. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So every trained soldiers who are in the war front, they don't have time to relax. They are always security what? Security vigilant. Watchful. Amen. Because you have been trained for that. So there is no time for Christian to relax. Oh, this year I don't want to pray. I'm going to relax this year. Last year I pray. I pray a lot. Amen. Praise God. Amen. It don't happen. You cannot say I bought petrol in my car last week. I'm not going to buy throughout this year. You need petrol all the time. To what? To use your car. So also you need the word of God. You need prayer. You need the help of the Holy Spirit all the time to carry on with life. And I believe the only time that person will relax is what? In the cemetery. Praise God. Keep your heart with all diligence. And Proverbs, what? Have explained to Rob, Proverbs 4, verse 23. Is the word it say? Keep your heart with all what? Diligence. He said, out of it, what? Spring out the issues of life. So take care of this heart. Amen.
Amen.
Protect it. Guide it from addiction. Amen. So if you don't guide it and the heart become addicted to that thing, you are in problem. Because out of the heart, what? Spring out the issues of life. Amen. You must avoid exposure to all forms of triggers. Keep the company of those whom you can be accountable to and who can encourage you in your journey to total victory. Keep the company of those that are helpful. Amen. Don't keep the company of those that cannot move you forward. You want to see something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Quickly, I was just going to say that, you know, like what we were discussing, because I'm just thinking about what we were discussing earlier, right? When it comes to like the types of addictions and everything,
yeah.
We're calling them types, but I think these are just manifestations, because I am of the idea that when it comes to addictions, right,
yeah.
That demonic influence,
yeah.
You can never have an idea without a spirit behind it, you know? So I believe there's one type of addiction, and that's demonic addiction, but then it manifests in different ways. It manifests in substance abuse, in behavioral, in you know, in craving for power and money and all of those things. Those are just manifestations, but the real reason behind an addiction is demonic oppression.
Praise God.
Yeah, so there was a time when I had two full-time jobs. And I worked in substance abuse, with substance abuse young people. I never saw any one of them recover. You know, so I think that in the world, they have to do something, and all they can do is manage a situation, damage control. But to totally free and liberate somebody from that kind of addiction and demonic oppression, it takes the cross of Jesus and the blood of Jesus Christ.
Praise God. Mm. That's a wonderful explanation. Mm. Praise God. Mm. Amen. Mm. So, I made mention of it before. Mm. I did not leave drinking because of power.
Mm.
I left it.
Mm.
I was able to break it. Mm. I took my stand because of the help of the Holy Spirit.
Mm.
This is what people don't have out there.
Mm.
So they create a way of helping themselves that is not too helpful.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
Mm.
I pray that God will help. Mm. So we, now in this lesson now, the way they explain in details and make it
when I started this topic, I said it's not just spiritual now. They make it a general lesson. Even people that are unbelievers, they will hear.